अभी हमारी जो टॉप नॉच स्टूडेंट है नीति दीदी, जैसे एल्सा दीदी टीचर्स पेट है, तो ये तो हमारी क्लास की मॉनिटर है, तो हम मॉनिटर साहिबा को इनवाइट करेंगे। नीति दीदी प्लीज।
ओके, थैंक यू पारुल जी फॉर दिस लवली वर्ड्स फॉर मी। मथेन वंदन भी महाराज साहिब, प्रणाम एंड जय जिनेन्द्र टू एवरीवन। टुडे आई हैव बीन टोल्ड टू टॉक अबाउट द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ जैन रिलीजियस एजुकेशन। So, Jain religious education is of utmost importance, especially during the present times. We are in the fifth era of a Sarpini Kal. It's called the Age of Darkness or Kalyug, as we commonly know. In this age, we see a slow and steady decline in the virtues of people, their moral values, and their faith in general. Children today are not ready to accept anything and everything blindly. They want a proper logical reasoning behind everything that they are asked to do, be it visiting temples, doing puja, celebrating parushans, doing pratikramans, fasting, etc., etc. So the question is, do we have a proper logical explanation which will answer all their queries and convince them and make their faith in Jainism stronger? So, and sadly, we as Jains have limited our religion to performing just these activities. But it's very important for all of us to understand that Jainism is much, much deeper than that. We have Jain physics, metaphysics, we have Jain chemistry, we have Jain biology, we have Jain maths, Jain geography, Jain cosmology, and so much more. And how many of us are even aware about that? Jain principles are not based on any blind faith. Our Tirthankar Bhagwans, they have minutely understood the smallest particle of this universe, and they have propounded Jainism on the basis of their omniscient knowledge. So the Jain principles can never go out of relevance at any point of time. Especially corona times have validated so many of our Jain concepts. Today we are talking about quarantining. In Jainism we already call it algam. Today we are wearing face masks, and in Jainism we already have the concept of wearing mupattis. Today science has come to prove that water has memory, and in Jainism we already say that water has chetna. So when we have such a rich treasure of knowledge with us, then why do we find so many of our Jains today turning to different faiths, going to different gurus in search of some magical mantra which they think will solve all their problems? I know of a Jain behen who is now a Brahma Kumari. And this is somewhere really, really disheartening. And do we ever wonder why all this is happening? The reason is obvious, and the reason is there is a lack of proper, strong, well religious education system which has the power to put an end to all human suffering. It's our good fortune today that we have Param Pujya Panyas, Dr. Shri Arun Vijayji Maharaj Sahib, who is tirelessly working towards imparting knowledge of our Agam Shastras to us. He is running multiple classes on varied Jain topics. He is highly, highly knowledgeable. He is highly, highly qualified. He is double MA. He is a PhD. And at the age of 72, he is still pursuing his further studies. And that is something very, very inspiring to me. Maharaji Sahib is an excellent teacher as well. Tinanam Taryanam is his motto in life. The way he explains extremely complex concepts of Jainism, and he makes them extremely crystal clear with the help of diagrams, is just incredible. His sessions are very, very interactive, informative, and interesting as well. There is not a moment of boredom in his classes. In the end, I will conclude by saying that we all must avail this golden opportunity of learning from Maharaj Sahib. I would request everyone to attend these classes regularly with full devotion, with full concentration. They should all sit with a pen and paper to jot down the important notes that Maharaji Sahib shares with us and make full use of Maharaji Sahib's treasure of knowledge. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Maharaji.
थैंक यू वेरी मच. खूब खूब आभार नीति दीदी, आपने परफेक्ट एवरीथिंग बताया जो वी ऑल एक्सपीरियंस एवरी डे.